Let's talk for a minute about multiplication and division specifically with the number zero. We have to be a little careful with the number zero because in certain circumstances, some funny things happen when we're dealing with zero. Let's start with multiplication. If you're taking zero and multiplying zero by any number, it doesn't matter what number it is, automatically this product will be zero. This is also true if you reverse the order. If you had a number times zero, the product is still zero. So as long as you have zero in a product, it doesn't have matter how many terms you have, the product will always be zero regardless. All right, now division, on the other hand, we have to be a little bit more careful. Let's start with having zero divided by some number, like zero divided by 5 or zero divided by 7 or zero divided by negative 10. It doesn't matter. If you divide zero by any number, you will get zero for your answer, and this is defined. All right, now the only condition is that your denominator is not allowed to be zero. So zero divided by zero is something else that we'll discuss in just a minute. But for now, if you have zero divided by any number, you'll get zero. Now, on the flip side though, if you had a numerical value that was being divided by zero, this is actually what's called undefined. This is not a meaningful quantity. You cannot take a number and divide it by zero. So there's a difference here. Zero divided by a number is totally fine, totally okay, and you get zero. Dividing a number by zero, on the other hand, is undefined. Now let's look at this one for a little bit. Why exactly? Why is dividing by zero not zero? Or, you know, why is it undefined? Well, let's see if we can explain that here for a minute. Before we do that, let me remind you about something. When you say A divided by B equals C, what you're actually saying is, when this is true, you're saying that A is equal to B times C. And we know this to be true. I mean, let's look at an example. If we said, what is 6 divided by 2? Then you would say 3. But why would you say 3? The reason you would say it would be 3 is because you're looking for a number that when you multiply it by 2, it would give you 6. And so sure enough, 2 times 3 is 6. So that's equivalent to saying 6 divided by 2 equals 3. Well, let's now look at this in the context of dividing by 0. If you had a number and you divided it by 0, and you know what, let's pretend that there was an answer. Let's say it wasn't undefined. Maybe we'll call it K or something. Then what would this be equivalent to saying? This would be the same as saying A, whatever your number is in the numerator, would be equal to K times 0. But what did we just say about multiplication by 0? 0 times anything is automatically 0, not whatever your A is. And so you see, this could never happen. You can't divide a number by 0 and get a quantity. And so that's why this quantity here is called undefined. So anyways, hopefully that helps clarify a little bit about how we multiply and divide by 0.